Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My beloved brothers and sisters, I have here with me the book Dar'u Ta'arud al-Aqli wal-Naql, which is also known as Muwafaqatu Sahih al-Manquli li Sarih al-Ma'quli, written by Ibn Taymiyyah Abu al-Abbas Taqiyuddin Ahmad ibn Abdul Halim. And the tahqiq is Muhammad Rashad Salim. And the tab'a here is Daru al-Faisaliyah. So I have the first volume, as you can see, it's Juz al-Awwal, and inshallah ta'ala, the page is, as you can see, 228. So inshallah ta'ala, I just want to share this statement with you, bi-idhnillahi al-kareem, from Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullahu ta'ala. Ibn Taymiyyah says here, وَالْبِدَعُ الَّتِي يُعَارَضُ بِهَا الْكِتَابُ وَالسُّنَّةِ التي يسميها أهلها كلاميات وعقليات وفلسفيات أو ذوقيات ووجديات وحقائق وغير ذلك. Ibn Taymiyyah says, the innovation التي يعارض بها الكتاب والسنة, the innovation which is opposed and people used to oppose it, the Kitab and the Sunnah, التي يسميها أهلها, in which its people, meaning the innovators, call it كلاميات, or some call it عقليات, or فلسفيات, or ذوقيات, or وجديات. So those are things which they call it. Some علم الكلام, علم العقل. Some call it علم الفلسفة. Some say ذوقيات, like the صوفية. And others, they call it وجديات. وحقائق, and some call it haqa'iq. وَغَيْرَ ذَلِكَ, and other than that, these terms are used to go against the Kitab and the Sunnah, he says. وَغَيْرَ ذَلِكَ, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah says, لَا بُدَّ أَن تَشْتَمِلَ عَلَى لَبْسِ الْحَقِّ بِبَاطِلٍ وَكِتْمَانِ حَقٍ. What is necessary is that it will consist of mixing the truth with falsehood and concealing the truth. وَهَذَا أَمْرٌ مَوْجُودٌ يَعْرِفُهُ مَنْ تَأَمَّلَهُ فلا تجد قط مبتدعا إلا وهو يحب كتمان النصوص التي تخالفه. He said, you will never find an innovator. He said, وهذا أمر ناس ماتا موجود, that is present. يعرفه من تأمله. The one who observes it will know that. فلا تجد, you will never find مبتدعا an innovator إلا وهو يحب, except that he loves كتمان النصوص التي تخالفه. He likes to conceal the textual evidences that oppose him. ويبغضها, and he hates it, those textual evidences. ويبغض إظهارها, and he hates to bring it out and for it to come out. وروايتها, and narrating it. والتحدث بها, and telling it to the people. ويبغض من يفعل ذلك, and he also hates the one who do that, who bring those narrations out. كما قال بعض السلف, as some of the كما قال بعض السلف, as some of the أئمة السلف said, ما ابتدع أحد بدعة إلا نزعت حلاوة الحديث من قلبه. That a person does not innovate an innovation except that the sweetness of al hadith is taken away from his heart. ثم إن قوله الذي يعارض به النصوص لا بد له أن يلبس فيه حقا بباطل بسبب ما يقوله من الألفاظ المجملة المتشابهة. And also he said, ثم إن قوله, his speech, الذي يعارض به النصوص, his speech which he is opposing with the textual evidence, لابد, it is necessary, أن يلبس فيه حقا بباطل, and he mixes it up with truth and falsehood. بسبب ما يقول, because of that which he's saying, من الألفاظ المجملة, he's using terms which are ambiguous and unclear and متشابه, that can carry more than one, that can carry more than one meaning. Inshallah ta'ala, that is the benefit that I want to share with you, inshallah ta'ala. And that is the issue which I was saying, which is الإجمال, حيث يجب الاستفصال من سمات أهل البدع, that speaking ambiguous, with when it's obligatory upon you to clarify exactly what you mean, is from the characteristics of the innovators, and Allah knows best.